Let's now check on the weather here in the Philippines with Pagasa forecaster Veronica Torres. Veronica.
Hi, good afternoon to you and to all of our audience at ENC. So currently, the northeast monsoon is affecting extreme northern Luzon, while easterlies is affecting the eastern section of the country. For Batanes, we're expecting cloudy skies with rains due to northeast monsoon. For Babuyan Islands, cloudy skies with scattered rains and thunderstorms is expected due to shear line. For Metro Manila and the rest of the country, we're expecting partly cloudy to cloudy skies with chances of localized thunderstorms. Also, we don't have any gale warning rays over any parts of the country, but be careful to those who will travel over extreme northern Luzon or the rest of northern Luzon area because on the coastal waters there will be moderate to rough. And that's the latest from Pagasa Weather Forecasting Center. Veronica Torres reporting.
Thanks, Veronica. Now, the private lawyers of Mary Jane Veloso want President Marcos Jr. to grant her clemency. Members of the National Union of People's Lawyers say sending Veloso back to the country is not enough. They insist Veloso should be given clemency on humanitarian grounds.
What is happening now is a political diplomatic track between two governments, more than a legal solution. She has been in prison on death row, as a matter of fact, for 14 years. Most importantly, from the evidence that we have on hand, she is a victim of human trafficking. It was totally unknown to her that the luggage that was given to her in Malaysia en route to Indonesia was packed with illegal drugs.
U.S. Defense Secretary Lloyd Austin reveals the existence of an American task force in Palawan amid tensions in the West Philippine Sea. In a post on social media platform X, Austin says he met American troops deployed to U.S. Task Force Ayungin during a visit to the Antonio Bautista Air Base in Puerto Princesa, Palawan. The air base is one of the 9 Enhanced Defense Cooperation Agreement, or EDCA, sites in the country. The Armed Forces of the Philippines has yet to respond to questions surrounding the role of the U.S. task force. Ayungin Shoal is where the BRP Sierra Madre has been grounded since 1999. China claims the entire South China Sea and has ignored a 2016 arbitral ruling in favor of Manila's claims over the disputed waters. It has since been executing dangerous maneuvers against Philippine vessels conducting legitimate maritime operations in Ayungin Shoal and other parts of the West Philippine Sea. The U.S. also commits more unmanned surveillance vehicles for the Philippines. Washington's defense chief bared this would be included in the $500 million aid for Manila that he announced during a visit in July. The Mantis T-12 is seen as a boost to the Philippines' capabilities in defending its territory. Austin says the U.S.-manufactured vehicle, equipped with sonars and light detectors, was among the priority assets identified by his Filipino counterpart for swift delivery to the Philippines. Nearly half of Filipino workers are using generative AI technology in the workplace, which is higher than the global average of 39%. To tell us what this means, we have on the line ABS-CBN correspondent Lady Vicencio. Lady?
Yes, Ron, the Philippines is ahead in adopting generative AI, artificial intelligence in the workplace, according to a recent study by Job Street by Seek. The study called the Coding Global Talent Report 2024, 46% of Filipino workers are now utilizing Gen AI monthly, which is higher than the global average of 39%. Writing and administrative tasks topped as the primary use for the technology at work. JobStreet Philippines Hire Marketing Lead Agustin Juanego said about 74% of Filipino professionals are eager to reskill on the technology to stay relevant with the changing workforce landscape. Key industries leveraging Gen AI include digitalization, data sciences, and information and technology, while industries involving craft and manual work remain cautious about its impact on jobs. With some industries starting to adopt Gen AI in the workplace, JobStreet is now seeing job descriptions for preferred applicants who are skilled with the technology. While the job search platform maintains human capital is irreplaceable by Gen AI, it advises employers to start upskilling and reskilling their workforce to future-proof their businesses. Ron?
Thanks for that story, Lady Vicencio.